This is a Walgreens blood pressure monitor. I took this into my doctor's office a week or so ago and compared it to readings the nurse got by using a regular blood pressure cuff. And this is reading 15 to 20 high repeatedly. So that makes it pretty useless. I'm going to take it apart and see how it works. A 6-volt DC motor running a little air pump. It'll run off of a 6-volt power supply or 4 penlight batteries. Penlight batteries won't last terribly long in one of these, so it's cheaper to have the power supply. Air from the pump comes into this junction block. This little brass piece here appears to be an orifice. Air goes from the junction block through this hose to the pressure cuff, and the line comes over to this mechanism, to this piece, and then comes back to the circuit board. I'm going to reconnect this to the circuit board, plug it in, and see if I can figure out what does what. This is basically what will be in your blood pressure monitor. You got a circuit board, a display, this ribbon cable, just like that clock that fell apart. This ribbon cable, the connections are just glued on there. There is no solder connection here. These are your control buttons, start and stop, switching between user 1 and 2, memory, and on the display we're going to have systolic, diastolic, and pulse. So the air pump, this thing runs like crazy if it doesn't have this little orifice in here. That puts back pressure on the pump to get a more even air supply to the pressure cuff. This distribution manifold, this plugs into your pressure cuff. This comes over to this gadget. And one leads to the sensor on the circuit board. I'm not really sure what this is for. I can't detect any air leaking out of it or anything else. This appears to be controlling the bleed off. Every once in a while, you can hear this thing click. Okay, we're plugged in. This is 6 volts. Hit start. This top number has been running 15 to 20 high when tested against the doctor's pressure cuff. So this is not too bad. And this is why this is getting junked out. I can't depend on these readings. And it was higher than this on a previous reading. I have disconnected everything from the pump. That little choke is still in here. We'll run that for a second. Not much air coming out of there. Now we'll just run the pump without that little choke in there. So it runs quite a bit faster without the back pressure on the pump. We'll unplug it, and this is the circuit board on the other side. Not much to see, a bunch of surface mount components, the heart of the mechanism, and that air hose, it plugs into that little black connection on the other side. And I'm referring to this piece. You're paying somewhere between $25 and $75 for a pressure monitor that's nothing more than a 6-volt motor driving a little air pump, some electronics, a display, and probably what's going to fail or get out of calibration is this thing, which appears to be monitoring pressure, and this gadget, which seems to be bleeding the pressure off of the pressure cuff. There are no user serviceable parts, and from the people I've spoken with, these do not seem to have a long life expectancy. They get out of calibration. There's no way to recalibrate it. The better approach would be the same type of pressure cuff that your doctor uses, along with a stethoscope. If you can learn how to use one of those, that's the most accurate way to go. as long as you learn how to accurately use it. Surprisingly, doing a Google search on this part number, you'll find out that this is a rotary diaphragm pump that delivers 1.8 liters per minute and a maximum output pressure of 400 millimeters of mercury, which is about 7¾ PSI. Searching for this, you find out it's a mini solenoid valve, which is normally open. When this starts to run, it powers this up and closes the valve. At the end of the test, it opens this valve and drains what air remains in this pressure cuff. After doing a few more tests, this is strictly a pressure sensor. This little thing is a very small orifice, and it allows air to bleed off at a consistent rate. I'm going to demonstrate that in a minute by putting that in water, and we can see air blowing in there. When your doctor uses his pressure cuff, he's looking at a gauge, and he's opening and closing a valve to bleed the air off at a constant rate, and that's what this does. This is also sold as an aquarium pump, and it would probably be operated at less than 6 volts. This little orifice in here puts back pressure on the pump. If you didn't have that, there was no load on the pump, this thing would start racing at a high rate of speed, pumping a lot of air, until the pressure cuff started coming up to pressure, and then the pump would slow down. So it would be delivering an uneven rate of air. This puts back pressure on the pump, and from the beginning to the end, it's delivering a consistent flow. So now I'm going to turn this on, and we're going to see how this works. So the pump is delivering air fast enough to inflate the cuff and overcome any loss here. So now it's deflating the cuff at an even rate until the test is done. And then that opened at the end of the test and released all the pressure in the cuff. This releases the air so slowly I couldn't hear it. The only way to verify it was putting it in water. A few problems or potential problems I can see. This tubing is very loose. It all but falls off of here. I'm kind of surprised that this doesn't blow off because of the air pressure. This is a real loose fit. There's no air filter on here anywhere. So if you were somehow to take in some dust or whatever with this pump, it would have an effect on this pressure sensor. And just like the clock failure that I reviewed, this stuff right here is just glued on there. And again, it has a piece of packing tape on here to reinforce it. When you go shopping for one of these, you just want to think about a little bird. Cheap, cheap, cheap.